Hello everyone. Thank you so much, Fuji, for giving me this opportunity. Thank you, PEP. It's really unbelievable that, you know, the hall is full and it's really making me nervous. So please, you know, just excuse me if I lose track. So I'll just start with my intro. In the meantime, let these people come. So I'll just tell you about my background, basically. I don't have anyone who's been into photography or anything related to art in the family. So the journey has been quite, I would say, you know, like, it's just like exploring on your own. You have nobody, and sometimes, you know, making a lot of mistakes, but learning from them. And I think that's how it should be. Mistakes teach you faster than anything. So my parents both are in government jobs, and I'm a BCom graduate. Then did my MBA, and just like so many of you, I started doing portraits in my college. Had bought camera in that DSLR fad everybody was into, so I was one of them. And eventually, that's when I realized that, you know, like, chidiya ki photo le rahe hain, pahad ki le rahe hain, sab cheez ki le rahe hain. But I think people were the, you know, subject that really fascinated me at that point of time. So I thought I'll just continue with this. So I started doing portraiture and then, you know, like, weddings side by side. So after, you know, there was a point when I had to choose between NID and IIM, because first year I couldn't get into anything. Second year I got into both. So it was really confusing. So my mentor at that point of time told me that don't go for a creative school or a art school. They'll teach you rules and it will take really long for you to get out of them. So I thought, okay, let's take the other part. Let's get into the B school side of it. However, they don't teach how things work. So yes, and inspiration for choosing this as my career is my mother. She's the most fussy artist I've ever come across in my life, who does everything just for herself, not for money, she doesn't care about anyone. She designs clothes for herself, so much so that she has kept a tailor at her home to stitch her own clothes. And you know, like, I'm like, how do you manage to do this? She's like, I don't care. I just want to wear all this. I said, you can go buy stuff. She's like, no, whatever I like is too expensive. So I thought I'll just make it. So I said, okay. And like there have been times she's just dedicatedly, you know, always doing those things. And, you know, she's the one who taught me everything about color that I know. Like, in my childhood, like when I used to go with her, you know, dyer's shop, and she's like, "Bhaiya, ye tumne galat kar diya hai. Ye color sahi nahi hai." So, like, I won't pay you. I'm like, "Sahi to hai. No, this pink won't suit me. I want exactly that pink." And you know, like when I got this dress, she had made it for me, and like when she shipped it to me, I said, "Okay, I got it. It's really nice." So she said, yeah, but you know, dyer did a mistake. I said, okay, I can't find any mistake. What mistake did he do? So she's like, you know, usne pink or orange bahut kam kiya hai. It was supposed to be more. I was like, okay. So I think that craziness, how to be so detail oriented, is something that I have got from her. And how I got my first wedding was, you know, like, at that point of time, there were hardly any candid photographers when I started. So there was this one moment, you know, like my friend's brother was getting married. And he was like, you know, I had done some couple shots for boyfriend, girlfriend in the college. They had posted on Facebook. So he's like, ki tum apni friend se poochho na, please. So I said, okay, I'll go. And then the journey has been just going on. Initially, being a woman, you know, my mother used to accompany me everywhere, wherever I used to go for shoots and all, because obviously, like, weddings were not that fancy at that point of time. Things have changed really in these 2-3 years. So, you know, like, it was really hard to convince them. And I think a lot of the men in the room do not realize this, but they have a lot of privilege in their hands. So things that you can do really easily, like girls have to work way, way hard for really small stuff. So eventually they realized that, okay, weddings are a safe zone. There's nothing, you know, like whatever apprehensions they had in their head were sorted. And finally, you know, they were okay with it. And in 2015, I passed out. And when I did my MBA, I passed out. And then I established Ombre. So it's been 4 years. The journey has been going quite crazy, I would say. So I'll start now. So basically, the agenda for the today is color theory in the wedding photography. How, you know, we can apply the rules that, you know, graphic designers, artists, painters use. And how, you know, like, we can create tones to create a mood and some golden rules to stick by. And I think by the end of this class, I'm so sure that I'll see a lot of people, you know, doing good color grading, good color post-processing. So, like, my job is not to see bad pictures. So I hope you like it. Okay. So, firstly, you have to see how to, you know, see color in an image. What all elements are there in an image, which basically, you know, bring color to it. So everything in the frame is basically a color, if you see. What color of outfits, skin is a color, hair is a color, scenery is a color. What you're using as a foreground is a color. What you're using as background is a color. Makeup, props, lighting, everything is a color. If you just, you know, break it down to color thing. So the whole idea is, you know, a lot of people keep asking me that, you know, what presets do you use? What do you use for color grading? The first point is, you know, you have to take picture in a certain way so that you remove all the clutter and then you can just focus on that color. So I would suggest that, you know, first you guys see how it has to be done and then get to the next color grading level. So the first or foremost rule is whenever you are post-processing your images, make sure that your skin looks natural. That is the only color reference that at least I use, that as long as the color of the faces is fine, I can play around with anything. So always, you know, like we are like, raw mein khich rahe hain, koi baat nahi, post-processing mein sahi ho jayega. But when you click in right white balance also, it kind of, you know, you just know right there ki what is going wrong, which color is distracting the image. So it's always good that though we have the privilege for setting white balance later on also, but it's always good if you could just settle it right there. It'll help you in eliminating the clutters. Wrong light, you know, we shoot weddings which have like a lot of pink lights, red lights, which can't be corrected, you know, no matter what you do. So don't use that light. You all like always use, it shall never come on the skin because it kind of creates, especially if it's a pink or a red, it can't be corrected in Photoshop also. So use good light. Then again, you know, like, kahin door se light aa rahi hai. We don't, you know, like, keep that in account. Just see that skin should be crystal clear. That's the first and the foremost rule. And there are times, you know, when there's backlit, the exposure meter would tell you that, you know, this is how it looks overexposed, underexposed. But eventually, just stop following that and go more by your intuition rather than it, and you'll eventually learn. Probably you might not get it correct for the first time or the second time, third time maybe, or maybe 10 times you might be doing it wrong, but don't do it at a wedding in each first take, you know, like practice. But then, you know, like eventually once you get a grip of, you know, what setting is getting you what, no book can teach you that. And the kind of knowledge then you'll have is going to be amazing. So I don't know, like just play with settings as much as you can. Don't show those bad pictures to anyone. That's okay. But some days, you know, those bad settings will only tell you how to get a good setting. So just to, you know, like how we are fooled by the exposure meter is like, you know, when we are taking sunset is happening or a sunrise is happening, there tends to be like exposure meter will say that. Okay. The exposure meter would say that, you know, the picture seems to be like under overexposed when you put it. But if you see the person, it's like really dark. So don't go by what your meter says. Go by your gut, go by your intuition. So I'm going to teach you about this color wheel. I'm sure you might have read it in school, maybe long time back. But we're just going to revisit this. So there are like type of colors. Red, yellow, and blue. These are the primary colors from which any other color is formed. Then there are secondary colors which are formed by mixing of two primary colors. Say, you know, if we mix red and yellow, we get orange. We mix yellow and blue. Just a second. Can you see the pointer? Yeah. Okay. So we see if we mix yellow and red, we get orange. We mix yellow and blue, we get green. We mix purple and green, we get blue. Now everything, every composition can go around this. And today I'm giving you a secret formula to get, you know, all your images go really nice, look visually very appealing, you know, how to get those colors in your picture. So it's all gonna come now. So this is on Adobe's page. It'll help you with everything. But just to give you a very simple idea how things work, and then I'll tell you in theory, practically also how it has been used. So the colors opposite to each other, say, isme yellow ke opposite purple hai, red ke opposite green hai. This combo is always gonna create a very stunning image. Obviously, image should be also good, but these are the elements which are gonna enhance it to a level that, you know, even a layman would get attracted who won't know anything about photography. That's how our minds are designed, probably our eyes are designed. So everything opposite each other, if you make that combo, you know, it is gonna create very interesting stuff for you. And this is available everywhere, and it doesn't have to be, you know, that you just have to follow yellow ke saath purple. It can be red, green also. It can be blue, orange also. And why I had shown this link to you was, it just shows you, even if you want to take a lighter shade accordingly, it should be just at equal distance and you can get the exact color palettes to work with. Now, how would this come into reality is, I'll just show you. So these are the type of color schemes. Primary colors I told you about. Secondary colors by mixing two primary colors. Mixing one primary, one secondary would lead to tertiary color. Then there are complementary colors which are opposite each other. Then there are analogous colors which are basically, you know, just together three or four of them in the wheel. Like say, we can just say any side, you know, like from blue to yellow. That whole thing is analogous colors if we use them together. Then we have triadic colors which are actually at equal distance from each other. So if you see red, blue, and yellow, they have a gap of 3-3 colors in them. Likewise, green, purple, orange. These are all, again, triad colors. Then we have monochromatic colors, which is basically an ombre of a single color only. And then we have compound colors. So now, what outfits your client is wearing? Where are you shooting? These are the things which can enhance your image in a much, much better way, can help you differentiate it. Suppose you're shooting in Ladakh or maybe, you know, any place, probably a garden also. You would be knowing what color is, you know, majorly prevalent there. Suppose you're shooting in a garden, you know, it's going to be a green. So you can actually do different things you know, when it comes to outfits, that according to this color wheel, what you can try for a complementary scheme. It's very simple. Then you can just ask them to wear red. First, start with primary colors ka combo. Then once you get hold of it, then you can start with triadic colors. Or maybe, you know, making it very if experimental, like, so I'm working, I'm going to be in a park. I'm on complementary mode here. These are the colors which, you know, like, what green is there? Obviously, thoda bahut green you can shadowify in Photoshop, Lightroom also. But it gives you a fair idea what color outfit your client shall wear. That if I'm doing a complementary scheme, just two colors, because it gets very confusing if we start directly with three or four colors wala scheme. So I'm taking this very simple. So if you are shooting in a beachy area, this is, you know, where your outfits, beach is blue, outfits should be in somewhere this range. And you can play with tones also, like pastels also, if somebody's, or maybe the other way around, somebody's asking you, you know, that I want to wear this dress, where should we shoot? Accordingly, you know, what outfit the person, he or she is wearing, you can choose a location. Probably she's really keen into wearing a pink. Or maybe something like this. You know that it'll look really good in this kind of atmosphere where there are a lot of greens. So there are, again, you know, couple of rules. Like, what is the kind of color we are looking at? How much weight you are giving it in an image? Maybe, you know, the couple is, say, wearing red and it's miniature. So, and it's taken against a sky. So blue is the major prominent shade. Again, some rules like that darker color should be always at bottom. You should just, you know, wherever you're taking a picture, wherever you're planning a shoot, whether it's a wedding venue or anywhere, you should always have that reference. There's a website called Pantone.com. You know, like, where you upload an image, it'll show what all colors are there in that image. It'll just show you that swatch. And it'll be very easy for you from there to figure out that, you know, this is the kind of guidance I need to give to my client. And colors, choosing colors as background and foreground, you know, like, looking your image only in terms of color, nothing else, no technicalities, no lenses, nothing. You know, you just see colors. Like, if probably that's how my style was formed, that I, like, everywhere, you know, I would just get attracted to colors. Wheresoever the most colorful thing would be, you know, I would like to take a shot there. No matter how fancy the decor is, and, you know, like, client would later on complain ki humare to decor ke saath pictures hi nahi hai. So I've tried, like, initially I just used to give this, but I realized that, you know, pehle client ka kar lo, then if you get time, then you do all of this, because they don't appreciate all of this. It's just that this is for your own growth, your own happiness. Probably weddings are so exhaustive that if you don't do it for yourself, you lose it at a point. And you're like, okay, I'm just a robot doing same thing over and over again, because weddings are exhaustive. So probably this motivation, you know, is the thing that keeps you kind of carry on, that, you know, what color I'll see, what color scheme I'm gonna play with today. These are the just little variations to make a boring job really interesting. And obviously, not choosing too many colors also. So now I'll explain a bit about colors and how, you know, what color stands for what and how it has been used in an image. So, you know, like, we shoot weddings, Indian weddings, red is the most important color out here. So red has a lot of meaning to it. It means leadership, determination, love, anger, passion, danger. In Chinese mythology, it's associated with good luck. Kind of, you know, you see KFCs and McDonald's having a lot of reds because it arouses the appetite. And it is the most attention-seeking color. There's a reason, you know, all of us have seen Ladakh pre-weddings. And you would see everybody is wearing a red gown. So there's a reason, because red is the safest color you can get with. If you don't find anything, you know, anything against a red would stand out. Anything in red would stand out for sure. So you can be really minimalistic with red, because no matter where you place that thing, you know, where you place your subject in red outfit, it'll stand out. So that's how you can play with it. Like in this image, if you see by complementary, you know, the colors are red and blue, right opposite. So that is how, you know, like there's so much clutter in this image, but still your attention goes directly to the red part. So that's how, you know, and it is not that the sky was this blue, you know, I got a perfect sky at that day. No, it is just going by theory. Okay, I have to maintain a red in this lehenga. That's it. And rest of my everything should go according to that. So that's when I, you know, that's what I keep in mind when I, you know, post-process my images. I have a reference point. Sometimes it's skin when you're shooting couples, but if it's elements, so unka ek real color rahe, otherwise designer would be like, mere colors ke kapde kharab kar diye. Client would be like, this was not my lehenga's color. He doesn't care about sky ka color or any other things. But to make it visually appealing, you can use other things. So that is what, you know, will help you stand out rather than taking the best camera. Everybody can buy a camera today. And, you know, like cameras have become so affordable. So that's, if you go in nitty gritty or maybe go into detail, that's how, you know, you will be able to stand out. Again, she was getting ready. She was wearing a red. And I just wanted, you know, to focus on a lot of red. So over here, you know, it, even in post-processing, there's a, you know, tinge in her skin that is red, because I just wanted it to look like that, which, you know, gives a very much character to it, which just says, you know, obviously, like, a lot of these moments happen, but always carrying something or the other that, okay, how do I add red to this image? Obviously, so this part that you see here, you know, this flare that is there. So there was this red polythene that was there in the room, which was lying from their wrappers all around, jo bridal ka packaging hota hai. So I just picked it up and incorporated in the image. Anything colorful just fascinates me. Again, red. Outfit is red. I had directed the client not too many colors in an image so that your focus directly goes to that point. Red props, red lips, and no, like half of the things were not like this. Like her lips were not that red. Okay, and if you see, my flower has a red bit of green leaf also. So that was the whole idea, to, you know, kind of add a very green tinge to their skin so that it just kind of sinks. And I matched the color of her lip to her dress and the flower just by, you know, like in hue and saturation modes of the Lightroom itself. This is a fun fact. Women have more tendency to see colors than men. I can understand that because recently, you know, like I came across a meme which said, you know, like I bought a red MAC custom lipstick. I don't remember its name. Ruby Woo, yeah. Ruby Woo it is. Yeah. So I showed my husband, see, I got this Ruby Woo. He's like, I can't figure out, you know, how it is different from the 5 or the 6 other reds you have in your case. But guys, every red is different. So, and I totally understand, like, men won't be able to process half of the stuff here. But I think that's what ladies can help them out with, that why a color is different from certain. Like for my husband, pink, magenta, baby pink, sub same hai. So next we talk about is orange. There's no middle ground with this color. It's like a very, very extremist color. We don't see it often in the pictures. You don't see people wearing more of oranges. because of red. Like, red has taken its place. So, you know, we kind of ignore it. But you can experiment a lot with this color because red is like really, really overrated and overly used. So the first thing, you know, when I shot for the first time in Leh, I made a point that I won't use a red dress for sure. Like, kuch bhi ho jaye, red shouldn't be there. So I think at that point of time only, you kind of differ your image from so many people who have shot there just by, you know, choosing a right color for an outfit. When the person, he or she, opens YouTube or social media, you know, like, even if your picture is not that great, his eye will go because it is going to be different from what he or she is seeing around. Nobody has time. Nobody will get into it, you know, like, they'll just scroll through it. But he'll wait a sec for your image because this is something new that he or she is seeing. It's a very warm, healthy color. And whenever, you know, you want to show something flamboyant, loud, you can use this color. That's why, you know, like, it's kind of tones of saffron, and saffron is associated with Hinduism, BJP. You see so much of that Hanumanji ka sticker that is there, prevalent on so many cars. So I think it's there's a reason, like, it's orange and it kind of catches your attention right there. And it's just not taken too seriously because of red. That's what I feel. And it tends to get overexposed. So whenever you're shooting a lot of orange in your image, you know, always you put your settings at a point that it's underexposed by at least one stop, so that when you process it, the, you know, the kind of orange you get is just perfect. Are you guys getting what I'm saying? You know, I think like half of the faces are blank, but that is how, you know, like, I process my images. So over here, again, orange and green, you don't see too many colors in an image. That's just like, even if there are, because obviously these are not, you know, perfect locations where everything is sorted. These are every time new. So, you know, if I see anything that is not going with my orange or green, I either change it in hue and saturation. And if it can't be done, I just eliminate it from the image. And, you know, this image was done in Chunda Palace. And the greens obviously looked really nice. The orange didn't have that tint to it. And there was no drama in that image. So just, you know, by putting that gradient wala filter with a little bit of orange, you know, I made a very boring image look interesting. That's it. It's not some fancy pose or some fancy technique. It's just going by what is there in your frame, what color is there, and what color would make it look more appealing. That's it. Again. So, obviously, it's a very normal silhouette. And just, you know, I just spend a lot of time, you know, trying to create something. And it was taken at sunset, but then I was just not feeling very great about it. So just after playing for a lot, many times, it just came out. So there's a reason why haldis are so, you know, attractive to shoot. I think it's the color of yellow. I don't know how many of us, you know, can relate to that. But I honestly feel that, you know, it's just looking at that yellow that makes you feel like you're shooting something really out of this world. It's the most visible color. It's cheerful, vibrant. It's the first wavelength of light that is seen by us all. And it is almost 2.5 times brighter than red. And whenever, you know, you see that there's a lot of colors in your frame, it's probably the color that you can add into an image, you know, that can just neutralize your whole image. Even when, you know, we're shooting against sunset or sunrise, you know, our eye just directly goes to that part. There's a reason for it. There's science for it. It's just, you know, like, no matter what he or she is wearing at that point of time, if you have that yellow in your image, that's why it looks so appealing. And it's always tends to get overexposed, underexposed, sorry. So always shoot it at plus one exposure, plus one stop. And whenever you're retouching or maybe editing color processing, you're never ever your skin color or your teeth should look yellow in that image. Because yellow is associated with jaundice, yellow fever. Your client won't feel good if he sees your skin to be yellow. So, you know, like we play a lot around post-processing, but these are just some rules that you can stick by, that it shouldn't look yellow. Maybe it looks really nice to us, some artistic creativity that we might have done, but for them, they just like, main bimar lag raha hu yaar is picture mein. And I've had clients telling me that. And according to Einstein, it kind of stimulates the whole mental process, activates memory. That's the reason I think they put haldi also, to make you all active for the married life. So again, yellow, lot of yellow. The image wasn't like this again. You know, he was wearing a yellow kurta, but the gendas were orange in the color, in the original image. So obviously I can't make his haldi orange. I made the flowers yellow just by, you know, it would have taken like 5 or 7 seconds just hue mein jaake. I just pushed the slider towards yellow. That's it. And now all my elements are balanced in the image. Again here, the flowers were again orange, and I kind of, you know, however, there's so much of clutter in there, but the presence of yellow just helps in, you know, distinguishing it from the rest. And maybe it's not a great picture, but, you know, it just stands out. So while you're posting or, you know, making blogs, you can go by these things also. These are the kind of images which will, you know, attract more people visually, where your colors are in balance. Again, it's basically taken on Nirav Modi's ad in the magazine. And in that, the image is, Priyanka Chopra's image is black and white. Okay, the jewelry was obviously golden. So, retaining the subject's color, which is like golden, I process the lady in a way more towards yellow, so that it just goes with my subject. Then we talk about green. Whenever you're shooting an old couple and, you know, who wants to feel young and probably where somebody is looking for a very, you know, that I want a very refreshing pre-wed. I want something different. Green should be your color. It just, you know, like every time they see it, it will kind of evoke some freshness. And it's the best for portraits. And I think it is the most readily available thing also when we are doing weddings. Because if you can't find anything, you can always find a nice garden or a backdrop. So here again, you can see that not too many colors. I just eliminate everything else. I did try to put their coat and dress also green, but it just didn't work out. It wasn't looking nice. So over here, you know, I just stayed with blue. Again, not too many things. Just keep one, you know, you start with one thing where you can put your focus on, that I will, you know, make my image around this thing, this colorful object, and everything is color. So over here, you know, the whole idea was that, okay, I'm getting a very interesting light on the leaf and it's all green. So I have to, you know, just focus on that part of it. Then comes blue. So 2/3 of the earth is blue, full sky. It's a very different blues have different meanings. It It can be associated with depression also. And if you're not playing very correctly with the, you know, blue, it might end up looking really shady, dark, and your client might not like it. So you should always know the correct blue to use in your images. Like dark blue, you can use with authority, trust, intelligence, dignity. Bright blue, kind of, you know, dependability, coolness, cleanliness, strength. Light blue, it kind of brings serenity and peace. And that's why whenever we go to beaches, this is the reason, you know, beaches bring calm to us, because they are blue in color. Underexpose it again by one stop, and whenever you process it, it will give you a better shade in your images. And blue are, of course. So you can actually, you know, a relevant color of your image is going to be blue. Accordingly, just by color theory, you can figure out that what color I can ask my client to wear so that it just looks really beautiful. So over here, again, single prominent use of a color, nothing else, no clutter. And the wall wasn't like this. Obviously, it was more like his turban. The one guy in third in the second row. It was the kind of blue. It was the kind of blue that was there. But again, because blues have very different meanings, the image wasn't kind of bringing peace or, you know, the bond that they guys share. It was a very sad sa picture lag raha tha. So just playing with the blue color, at least the image looks decent. Again, blue sky, not too many colors. I just, you know, like there's a brown and a blue color and a third color, which is also very close to blue only. Then we have white. White can be associated a lot with luxury because white ko bahut dhona padta hai aur white ko maintain karna padta hai, and not everybody can. You have to be like really rich to maintain whites. I think that's why those Saudi guys, whenever I visit Dubai, I'm like, you know, there's a reason these guys wear white. So it can show faith, hope, purity. And it's the only color, you know, if you're planning to use too many colors, it should be always against white. Otherwise, it'll lead to a lot of confusion. Never ever the attention would go to the subject. It's a very relaxed, and you know, like if you look at the campaigns that are done by big fashion photographers, you'll see all these things relevant over there also. Like, why, you know, like most lavish weddings, the brides would wear white, because white again is a sign of luxury. So, you know, most of the people ask me, like, you know, you should always, if you want to portray to somebody that, you know, I have rich clients, you know, like I have a, but you don't have actually, but, you know, like we also don't have, but that is how, you know, you just trap them into thinking you're, when you shoot somebody in white with lot of whites, it tends to look really rich. And it's really easy, like you can't, again, you have to be really careful, because when you're placing anything against white, if something is really like wrong by a slight point, it'll come out. Your all your say kamiyan hoti hain jo wo kafi clearly dikhne lag jati hain white ke against. So always, you know, start shooting against white only when you think you are just perfect. So not exactly white, but kind of an off-white. Again, if you see in this image also, it was in, her dress was exactly completely white, but over here you would see a more of an off-white tone, because the sky on that particular day was really cloudy, very dark, and you know, like the dress was looking very, it was just standing out, but not in a good way. So I think, you know, I just touched a bit upon the white balance of the image and her particular, and it just kind of fell in place. So these little things enhance your images. We do as much as what you guys do, but just take care of these little things more. Again, white over here, I wanted to play with the smoke. Smoke is white. And, just to get the right feel of the image, I shot it in a black and white mode only so that I know exactly where, what texture the hand is creating and how much smoke is required and how much smoke is just not required. So purple again is, highly associated with royalty and wealth. I don't have images to show for purple because none of my bride listens to me. If I tell them ki aap purple pehen ke aana, like I've been asking my brides, from good one and a half year, nobody listens to it. So I don't know when I'll get to, shoot somebody in purple. But it's a beautiful color, and I think, whenever somebody is planning to wear a blue next, this is a color you can suggest them. So now you got to know a lot about colors. How you can use these colors? Your complete concepts can go on. The possibilities are endless here. Like one season, you can actually work upon color harmony. Suppose kisi location ka koi color palette hai, you can actually use the same color palette for outfits also. It'll bring a very, I'll show some examples to, show that what I'm trying to say. So over here, I've done a complementary color palette. So you see that the lady is holding a candle, and there's a light orangish here on the right of the frame. So just to make it more interesting, we kind of added a blue flare with something blue which was available at that point of time. Just, and it was a very, very, deliberate choice to use a blue, because if you see that wheel, if you pick that color, the blue is the exact color that will come opposite to it. If we are talking about complementary colors. Green and red. See, my subject is not very large, but your eye will write, just hit there because she's wearing red. And against a green, again, they are opposite on the complementary wheel. Blues and yellows. Blues and yellows again. Now, the second, you can use complementary colors as color contrast in an image. The second thing is that you blend your colors with the landscape of the or the scenery that is there. So over here, we went into a jungle and it was all browns and greens. So I had, and we were planning to shoot at somewhere close to, when it just, not exactly blue hour, but right before the blue hour, where it just is like very light tinges of blue start coming in. So if you see their outfits very carefully, they have been, are in the tones of blues, greens, and with grays. And that's what you see in the frame also. The overall scenery and the landscape. Even in processing, there's a bluish feel to it. So everything is deliberately done. And all of you can also do that. Again, have a look at her skirt. It is exactly going with the, the landscape of Pangong. The water is blue, so I asked her to wear a blue. And the hills are brown. I asked the guy to, just don't wear fancy clothes. I don't want you to wear gowns or anything. Just please, there's just only one request, that follow these colors carefully. That's what I have briefed them. And the guy is wearing brown shoes, brown pants, which are really going well with the hill out, just behind it. And if you see where these guys are standing, there's a gray also. On the part that they're standing, that's gray. And the guy is wearing a gray jacket. So, everything counts in that image. It is very well balanced. And I think all of you can do this. You don't have to ask them to spend, a lot on their outfits, but just guide them, because they don't know what they are supposed to wear. You should be the one who would be telling them that, you know, I just want, and I think everybody can do that. You don't have to have a fancy camera for making good pictures. You can just tell them and you can see the kind of difference it will bring into your images. Again, two colors. We had gone to Andamans, and if you think of Andamans at a point, you'll just get that blue and white kind of thing in your head. And that's the brief we had given them, that, you know, we want you to wear blue and white. That's it. Again, the bride was wearing golden outfit. Her jewelry was also golden. Again, I used the same lifafa technique to create a lot of goldens around her, just to, you know, enhance a otherwise boring image. So now in this image, obviously, my relative, my reference point was lehenga. I can't change the color of that lehenga. And of course, I can't even change the color of the airline also. And this thing, that this corridor that you're seeing in the image was actually not in this color. It was in gray color. But if you now see it, it has been deliberately turned to a tone which is very similar to lehenga's tone. Just to, you know, make it look perfect. Otherwise, you know, like the moment was there, the shot was otherwise also very beautiful, but that is where your processing comes in and, you know, the image looks even more appealing. That I just, you know, like playing in hue and saturation very close to what my lehenga looks like, and that, you know, if you see this part of the image, it is exactly similar to what the lehenga looks like, the right to the lehenga. Now, these are like difficult compositions, but this also has been done if we keep in mind. So we spoke of triadic colors. So it's exactly that. It was a pale shot. The colors that you see have been added. It was a plain white bag, not white, I would say, but a very dull, jaise mitti light sa color tha. The original image was like that. And it was boring. For me, it was boring. And I just wanted to add something to it. But obviously, a single color was making it look very fake again. Not everywhere, you know, single color would look nice. I added two colors. Second color se bhi wo feel nahi aa raha tha. So I added a third color. Now, the confusion was, you know, what colors to add. So, very simple theory. You know, whenever you're planning for three colors in your head, this is the scale that you follow. So, basically, when you'll see that this is more of a triad composition, where these colors have been chosen deliberately, because I don't know what color will look good or what color will not look good. But color wheel knows. So you can just blindly follow it. Again, red, yellow, and blue. The picture looked nothing like that. It was a simple silhouette with just little bit of blue. And there were these fields behind. So everything else has been, you know, processed very carefully, keeping the color theory in mind. And a lot of people ask me, like, you know, what is the secret behind tones and everything. So most of it is what I've told you. Please let me know your feedback, you know, like if you are using these things and if it's helping you in some way. Also, I would like to say, you know, that cameras don't make a difference. Your vision makes a difference in everything that you do. So think what you are doing differently, how you can make your image look different. Techniques, yes, it's important to know techniques. But after a point, everybody will know techniques. Maybe 2 years, kisi ko 2 saal lagega, kisi ko 5 lagega, kisi ko 10 lagega probably. But eventually, you know, everybody will read the same books. What is that element that you can add? And only you have that. Some people naturally have those aesthetic sense, like what color to use. But never ever it should hold you back, because you know everything is present. If there's like, you can read a lot about colors and you can apply it. And why this particular image I'm showing, because it is a bit different from everything else that I had shown. It is, so this particular client wanted like really dark and moody pictures. And what color did we talk about is like dark, moody, depressing, blue. So both of them were wearing blue blazers. Over here, we have the guy is not wearing a blue blazer in this particular picture. So whenever you want to do something really dark, never ever wear bright colors. That's it. There's only one rule for it. Thank you. Any questions?
So we'll start from the center. Okay.
Hi, I wanted to know, while you are doing the color corrections, for example, specifically about the image where there are the hands, couple hands, and
this one?
No.
Okay.
Which?
Ah.
Yeah. And you said the background was of that blue.
Yeah.
And then you got it into this shade or something.
Yeah.
So how do you decide that you want this particular blue and not that blue to set up some mood? For example, I thought maybe that mood would have got a lot of... this for a couple shoot probably is giving me a lot of serious kind of look.
Okay.
And that blue would have got a very funky and very cheerful kind of. That's what is my perspective. So how, as a photographer or as an editor, you decide that where to stop basically while editing?
Okay. See, again, you know, there's everybody has a different eye for a color and everybody has a different liking. So what you like will be your style. This particular blue is something that I like. Okay. And... when you play around a lot, you know, you only know, there's no technique to it, you know, where to stop. There's no limit. As long as my skin color is not getting disturbed in the image, I play around a lot. And when you play around a lot, and you shouldn't play too much also, because I have spoiled some images where I am just going on and on and on till the point ki abhi sab kharab ho gaya and you just throw it away. So, you know, like, once you get that feel, please bas usko band kar do wahin pe. That, and nobody can teach you that. It's right in your heart only. When you'll see it, you'll say, "Haan, abhi acha lag raha hai." That's it.
Thank you.
My question is not related to color. I just want to ask, being a lady wedding photographer, did you face any specific challenges while doing photography? Like you feel distracted or what? Did you face anything like this? Would you like to share with us?
Yes.
Completely different topic.
I think we can talk on like for really long on that. Yes. Initially, you know, I had shot in the interiors of the country, UP, MP, or maybe Punjab also. Where like, you know, like people would just see me and they'll just come specially to me. Haan, ek photo khich do, because they had never seen a female photographer in their life. So, yes, like the kind of attention you get, you know, you used to get. Now there are a lot many women in the field. I think it's really good now. But earlier, you know, it kind of used to make you feel a bit uncomfortable, but then you just get used to it. I haven't had like really drastic accidents or incidents where, you know, I had to stand up for myself, luckily or unluckily. But yes, attention is the only thing, unwanted attention. You know, you're doing your job and somebody comes to you specially that, okay, meri please photo khich do. And you're just right in something, trying to capture something. I think that's it. Like, I haven't personally faced something really drastic. Thank you.